I'm here talking about the Novation Impulse controllers. And one of the powerful features that it comes with is AutoMap 4, the latest version of Novation's software that bridges the gap between your hardware controller and your favorite music software. I have Pro Tools 9 here running, and right out of the box, with the new wizard that comes with AutoMap, I'm able to simply just touch and go so I can focus on my creativity with my pans and my faders. But where AutoMap really separates itself is within plugins and virtual instruments. Here, I'm just going to launch a standard EQ within Pro Tools, and simply by launching it, I can just move my dials and control right out of the box. But we go a step further, and if you really want to dive deep into it, you can simply say, hey, I want to control a certain dial with a certain hardware dial. How do I do that? It's as simple as hitting learn on the Impulse, moving any control you'd like on your plugin, and then moving your hardware dial. And just like that, you're able to, you know, mix with your ears and not with your eyes, if you will. So that is a great feature that we think people will find keeping themselves really, you know, productive with their music and not really technical. So this is a great feature at its price, and I think AutoMap 4 is really going to change the way people approach using their MIDI controllers with their DAW. One of the really cool features about AutoMap 4 is that we now incorporate what we call wizard setups, which really walks you through how to set up your keyboard controller with your favorite DAW. So in this case, I have the AutoMap 4 screen up and I have Pro Tools, and it's asking me which product do I have, Impulse 25 or 49 or 61. So I'll go ahead and select the 49, and you hit set up Pro Tools. This is a really great thing because, you know, AutoMap is asking you, hey, do you want me to control all the plugins that you have installed with this program? So if you have so, hit enable plugins. In this case, I'll skip. And it's gonna just hit continue, and it nice large pictures and easy to read directions allow you to just kind of walk you through the directions of how to set up this right now. It doesn't get into a deep manual. I just wanna plug and go. And at the end, bam. There'll be a green dot right next to your software indicating you have successfully installed and connected and set up your controller with your favorite DAW, which we think is really easy and for people to open the box and go and make music. Also new with AutoMap 4 is that it's built into the keyboard itself for even easier access to your favorite DAW. So right here in the middle, the data dial, if I press and hold it, I can now select Main Stage, GarageBand, Reason, Ableton Live, a selection of DAWs, and I can instantly select it, let it go, and my keyboard is ready to control that DAW. Also new with AutoMap 4 is we've enhanced the GUI or the screen you're looking at when you're editing with AutoMap. So now when you move a dial, you can see really easily which dial you're controlling, what it's named, and if you want to get deeper into it, you can simply just press that, and at the bottom of AutoMap, this edit assignment screen comes down. So if you want to get deeper into it by assigning the range you want this to control it. So AutoMap is really great for the people who just want to walk up and control their DAW the way they want to, or for those guys that want to dig deep under the hood of their plugins or virtual instruments and assign your own user templates. AutoMap really makes that easy because you no longer have to, you know, put tape and write with a marker what a control is. You can save all this stuff in AutoMap and it names it or renames it as if it were your own customized plugin. So that is a really cool feature, and again, it makes it really simple to know what you are controlling and where, and that is the power of AutoMap 4.